Okay, so these have to be an amber colour where I live. They can't be white or red. So I'm going to get two new globes and I'm going to try and spray them so that they've got a coating of amber colour. You can get amber globes here, but not the ones with the pinpoint sticking out sort of above the other one. So there's one just there, and the other one's up here. Okay, I've drilled the holes down so that the globe sits right down in it and only the glass sits up. You don't really want it over the metal bit. I'm thinking this could be a success. I can see that the in the picture the right hand indicator is more visible than the left. However, it's legal now, it's the right colour, but I might have to look into that left hand indicator as you're looking at the front of the truck, or the actual right hand indicator. As you can see, I've swapped the globes around, and that's a globe problem, not a an electrical problem. So could be that one of them's a 24 volt, one could be a 12 volt. I'm not really sure yet. Okay, well, what the problem was there is there's two different globes from different manufacturers. The one on this side was a Repco, and this one was a different one, and it was just built to be dimmer. So I'll get a new one now. Okay, it's all good. The dim one could have been purchased from Super Cheap Auto, and these bright ones are Repco. With this truck, I know that the fan motor doesn't work. There's a connector just down there. Might be able to just see it. It's pretty dark though, with no lead going to it. Another problem is the washer wiper water motor doesn't work. That's fairly old. I'd say that would be the original one. The speedo cable doesn't work. I've just disconnected it there. I think I just need a new cable. And inside the cab, the interior dome light doesn't work either. I don't actually know where the switch is for this, but I'll get to the bottom of it. The list of things to do on this truck is fairly extensive. It does have a good engine and gearbox. The rest of the truck's good. There's just a few of the electrical, you know, like the fan and the water motor and things like that. Another thing that's gone out on this truck is the window motor. It seems to have come loose, so I've got to get to the bottom of that. The other side, the right hand side's okay, but it's the left hand side driver's window. If you're in the club, you know, you got to get a once a year roadworthy certificate. And if you're a mechanic or in the trade and you've got friends, it's easy to get a pink slip. But if you're an outsider, of course, you're never going to get a pink slip unless everything's working. And besides that, yeah, I'm just somebody who likes to have everything working. It doesn't have to be modified or new or anything like that. It's just got to work. With the cover removed, You can see that this is a very, very complicated part of the truck. It's got some type of almost points some sort of lever there, and copper coil. That's the motor there. That's probably the motor for the wipers. But yeah, it's very complicated. That's the window washer there. I'm pretty sure it comes in one unit. Okay, so all the fuses are all good. I've had a look at all of them, and they all seem good. I think that this would be the interior cab light, so that's your outside lights for driving. But to turn it is to have the light on in the cab, and there's nothing there. So I removed that cruise control module. I'll say that probably connected to the carburetor, and this was the throttle actuator. But it's well past its use by date, and it can't be repaired. And I don't really want cruise control anyway. I also removed the window washer bottle, because I've got another one. I bought one with a pump on it that I'll just connect it to the pump, and that'll be the water supply. And it's got to go there anyway. With the old water pump and whatever all of that is, you know, I don't know, it looks very complicated, and there's really no need for it. It's just a bottle and a motor is all you need. So I'll just remove the cover and see what's behind that. So this is the window wiper control. I'd say that pin would slot into there, and really all this is just a holder for the pump. The pump just sort of sits on there separately. That would be my guess, but I've got to say I really don't understand any of this these components here. One interesting thing is I don't actually see any wires running to this water pump. There's nothing there, or on the back or the top. So I'll turn it on now and see if these components do anything. I've got to get this the speedo working, and I've noticed here it looks like the end's broken off the lead. It's called the top lead because it's the higher one of the two. This actually goes down to the gearbox, and this one runs into the cab. So yeah, we're underneath the truck now, and here's the cable, and there's the gearbox, and it runs along to the back of the gearbox there, and that's it there. So there's the drive shaft and the back of the gearbox, and it travels around and up to the engine bay. Okay, so I've got the cap off, and we'll see, that's completely bent. That's been bent up in there. Oh wow. Now that's what I thought, there'd probably be a reason why it was busted off up the top. And that's been curled right around that way, and it comes out here. You may be able to see that it's all there, the slot for the cable to go into. So something's happened. This is twisted around on this side. My guess is that it's designed to break up there instead of in the gearbox. Either that, or this vehicle's travelled at more than the legal road speed. Interestingly, when I drove this truck to where I live, the speedo did work for about 30 seconds, so that's encouraging. It's got one retaining bolt, that's it just there, it's undone from the other side, so I'll take off the cable and measure it just to make sure I'm getting the right part. So there was just a nut on the front there holding that bracket on. That's the rear of the speedo cable to cruise control housing there. There are the hoses. One hose goes into the cab. And it's got a longer hose that comes down here. And it used to go to this actuator that went to the carburetor. So I don't want cruise control, I'm only interested in this front bit, and there seems to be, if I lift up this part here, you can just see in there that there's like a clutch and some type of a gasket or a spacer, and this spring on top, and this runs into inside the body for the cruise control, and that's where the speedo cables go in, and it looks like it's adjustable. I can be reasonably sure that the gears inside work, because you may be able to see the black one turn. If I turn that there, I might be able to see that black one turning. So I'll go and clean out this body a bit better. These two move, but that one, you know, the gear inside there's stable. Actually, I think one cable drives the top there, this one, this gear, and that'll drive the other cable via this this cog here. Okay, so that's it from the top to the bottom. So from the engine bay to the gearbox. So we can see here that the end's broken off. So that's fairly good evidence that I need a new cable. That's the bracket. And I cut the cable with a grinder, angle grinder. And that's the twisted bit there that went into the gearbox. Okay, I've got a speedo cable. It's 63 inches long. Speedo cable, upper and lower. Well, I know mine's the lower because it's 63 inches. The code I've got here is ATP Y804. Here it gives part number Y804. Just here is interchange part numbers. I think they're mostly similar. 895-300-1989 and 440-20. 400-111 and 3152. As well, I've got a water bottle and pump for the windscreen water. The seller is Wind Deal, WINDDEAL, 12 volt, 1.8 litre, universal car windshield washer reservoir pump bottle kit, jet switch. That was on eBay at the 2nd of the 1st 2017. One interesting thing is the this fuse box here, or the back of the fuse box. It's got this sort of I don't know, it's hard to tell what it is. I don't know whether anybody's put any grease in the back of it, or whether it's caught on fire, or what the story is here, but you can sort of, with your fingernail, you can remove this sort of, it could be burnt plastic or old grease out of the fuse, back of the fuse box there. I think I may have made a record of that before. What I'll do is I might get some brake parts cleaner or carburetor cleaner and just give it a bit of a brush off and try and clean it up. From what I can see, the actual framework's there. If you dig your nail into this plastic part here, it's all still there. So yeah, that's it inside, and as you might be able to see there, the fuse box looks very healthy inside. That's a shot taken a bit further away where it might be easier to see.
There's a bolt there in the middle. I don't know whether I can remove the outside of the fuse box from the inside. Anyway, if I have to, if there's any problems in the future, I'll have to get to the bottom of what's going on there eventually. But I might just back off that bolt in the middle and just see. Well, for a few seconds there, I wasn't sure whether I was digging a great big grave for myself. Anyway, you can see there that each cable goes onto a sort of a prong here, and that goes into there, slots into one of those. The good news is that Chevrolet have made this two parts. You can probably order this with the cables coming off the back, and you just wire them up. The bad news is that in there I see the same type of situation where there's some type of grease. You know, it could be deliberate, could even be from the factory, I'm not sure. But the good news there is that it's consistent and it's throughout the entire assembly. It's not confined to one area where you could say there's been a fire. There's no evidence of a fire. I think it's just old electric grease. So that's fairly good news. There's actually two terminals here. There's that one and that one, and they're both exactly the same. So now that's definitely some type of electric grease in there to stop any type of electrical rust. Two terminals there, and two the same on the other side. Okay, so this is two sections of this the back of the fuse box, and they can be removed. So this thinner one comes out this side, and I'd say this big one will slide out that way. So that comes out that way, and this one here, this one would have just come from this side here. So that's all one section, as far as I can tell at this stage. Okay, so I've given that a fairly good clean out. What I used was, that's just fuel, and I used this for that back part going into the cab. And I use this long, fairly stiff bristle brush for inside the terminals that sit into that the other part. Now I use some brake cleaner, I just sprayed it in and I let it all dry completely 100%, and then I'll probably put a little bit of grease on it and put it all back together. When working with any solvent or petrol or fuel or anything, wear eye protection and skin protection.
Okay, so that's the speedo drive, and what I've done is I've got it lightly greased up. You don't want to pack this full of grease because you won't be able to turn it, and you could break your cables. So I've washed some of the grease out, and that's what it looks like inside. I don't know how well that's going to show up. There's just a bit of grease down there, and also some of this WD-40. If you find that this spring sort of, when you take this apart, anyway, if the spring sort of bends up a bit, you can always adjust this. There's a very small nut that comes off the end here.